Ameboid locomotion is basically the migration of the entire cell in relation to its surrounding. Before we see how the cell actually moves, let me give you an analogy that will help you understand the mechanism of ameboid locomotion later on. Let's say you have gone for a walk, and suddenly you come across a puddle. You don't want your feet to get wet, and luckily for you, there are few bricks to walk over the puddle. But they don't cover the entire length of the puddle. So first, you move to the last two bricks. What you do next is important for our discussion. You move the first brick forward, and then step on it. Then you move the next brick forward, and then step on that. This way you keep moving bricks and yourself forward. Ameboid movement of the cell occurs in a similar fashion. In this, the cell membrane moves how the bricks were moved. It jumps from backward to forward. And the cell body moves how you moved. It slides over the jumping membrane. So basically, you need to understand two things in ameboid movement: how the membrane jumps forward, and how the cell body slides over it. So let's see how exactly this happens. First, the movement of the cell membrane. Usually, the cell is attached to its surrounding through the receptors on its membrane. Now let's say the cell needs to move in this direction. For this, the cell membrane at the rear end of the cell is pulled inside the cell by endocytosis. This results in shrinkage of the cell membrane on this side of the cell. Endocytotic vesicle created with this membrane is transported to the front end. Here its membrane is inserted to the cell membrane by the process of exocytosis. So the cell membrane over here expands. The newly added receptors here attach the cell to a new area. Many such vesicles are continuously created from the rear and mid portion of the cell, shrinking the back edge of the cell membrane. They move to the leading edge and get inserted into the membrane over there, expanding the cell membrane on this side of the cell. So this is how the membrane is moved. This is equivalent to moving bricks in our analogy. Now let's see how the remaining cell body is moved. Movement of membrane creates a pseudopodium in the direction in which the cell needs to move. In this pseudopodium, a network of actin and actin-binding proteins, such as myosin, is synthesized. The interaction between actin and myosin causes this network to contract, thus pulling the cell body toward the pseudopodium. In this way, the cell body is moved. This is equivalent to you stepping over the bricks. Thus, the entire cell has moved. Please note that I explained the process in step-by-step manner, but actually everything is happening simultaneously and continuously, moving the cell forward. So this was the mechanism of ameboid movement. Now let's talk about the control of this movement, which is called chemotaxis. The direction of the movement is guided by certain chemicals. Such chemicals are called chemotactic substances. Usually, the cell moves in the direction of the source of this chemotactic substance. Let's say this cell wants to call this cell. For this, it will release a chemotactic substance. From here, the substance spreads in all directions. And as you can see, as they go farther, their concentration falls. Of course, the cell is releasing this substance continuously. Now look at the concentration profile of chemotactic substance around this cell. On this side, the concentration of chemotactic substance would be higher, because this side is closer to the source. On the other side, the concentration would be lower, because it is away from the source. A mechanism, which is not clearly understood yet, detects this difference in concentration and tells the cell in which direction to move. And the cell moves in that direction by the mechanism that we discussed earlier. The movement towards the source of the chemotactic substance is called positive chemotaxis. Sometimes, the cell moves away from the source. That is called negative chemotaxis. So this is how the ameboid locomotion of the cell is controlled. Now, the cells migrating with ameboid locomotion are as follows. First, white blood cells. They are the most common type of cells, showing ameboid locomotion in the body. Their movement out of blood vessels into the tissue occurs by ameboid movement. Fibroblasts move into damaged areas for repair by ameboid movement. Lastly, during the development of embryo and fetus, embryonic cells need to move long distances from their site of formation to the area that is being developed. This movement occurs by ameboid locomotion. So this is where ameboid movement is needed to migrate cells. That's all for ameboid locomotion of the cell. Now let's have a quick summary. In ameboid movement, the cell membrane is transported from the rear end of the cell to the leading end by continuous endocytosis at the rear end and exocytosis at the leading end. The pseudopodium thus formed pulls the remaining cell body, thus moving the entire cell. Its direction is guided by chemotactic substance. And usually, the cell moves in the direction where the concentration of the chemotactic substance is higher. The cells in the body showing ameboid movement are white blood cells, fibroblasts, embryonic cells, etc. That's it for this video. Click here to read the notes on this video at our website. You can also explore our entire physiology animation video library over there. To support my free content creation, first leave a nice comment, and then share the video with all your friends and colleagues. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.